We will be discussing the fourth problem, that is preparation of personal account of Swami. Now, this is exactly the opposite of third problem. In third problem, we have seen that we sold goods to Sudha and ultimately Sudha settling the account. But here, the beginning of the problem, it states that amount due to Swami. As discussed earlier, whenever the business is due to someone, that means the business has to pay them money. Why the business should pay them money? Probably the business has purchased goods from them. They are our suppliers, or indirectly later you will see they are our creditors. Now, the transactions are related to the month of January. So the first transaction given to us is rather an opening balance, which states that on 2nd January, amount due to Swami 12,000. So we have to pay to Swami. So we already discussed when we have to pay to someone, that here it is Swami's account, the name of the person is Swami. So this Swami, we have to pay money to Swami. That means his account will show us a credit balance. The opening balance, if at all given, will be put on the credit side. So therefore, 12,000, we will write it in the amount column on the credit side. As you all know, the by word is constant in the particulars on the credit side. So we will say this is the balance, and we are using the word brought down because it is opening balance. Now, the date is 2nd Jan. Okay. Now, the second transaction is on 8th. It is goods purchased from Swami, rupees 16,000. Goods purchased from Swami, rupees 16,000. So, let us write the journal entry for purchase of goods from Swami. You all know it is purchases account debit to Swami's account. So, we are crediting Swami's account as per the journal entry. It means in his account, the amount should be written on the credit side. The amount being 16,000, enter it in the amount column, 16,000. Now, the constant by. The reason for crediting his account is we purchased goods from him. So, we will write the word purchases in the particulars, and the date of transaction is 8th Jan. Now, next transaction is on 15th. It states that returned goods to Swami, or goods returned to Swami. Out of the total purchases made, some might be defective. As a result, we are sending back the goods. So when we send back the goods purchased, it is called purchase returns. So what will happen in this? Swami will receive the goods. So we'll apply the rule debit the receiver. So our journal entry becomes Swami account debit to purchase returns. Swami account debit to purchase returns. As a result of this journal entry, we are debiting Swami's account. So let us go to the debit side and enter the amount first in the amount column, 5,000. And you know, 2 is constant. In particulars on the debit side, and the reason for debiting the account is purchase returns. Now, it is taking place on the date 15th. So, 15th Jan, you can write 2014. Now, the next transaction is on 20th, which is cash paid to Swami. Cash paid to Swami, rupees 6,000, cash paid to Swami, rupees 6,000. So we paid cash to Swami, means Swami is the receiver. If we write journal entry, we write it as Swami to cash. So as per the journal entry, we are debiting Swami's account with rupees 6,000. So we'll write 6,000 in the amount column. Again, you're writing 2, which is a constant. The reason for debiting Swami's account with 6,000 is we are paying cash. So we write cash in particulars, and the date is on 20th. Now, next transaction is on 24th. Goods purchased from Swami. Goods purchased from Swami, The journal entry being purchases to Swami, as you all know. Now again, Swami's account is to be credited with rupees 9,000. So on the credit side, enter the amount 9,000 in the amount column, and the constant by, the reason is purchases, so we write purchases. Then the date being 24th. Now that's all. The last transaction states that Swami's account is settled by check with a discount of 10%, meaning whatever balance you have to pay to Swami, you are paying the money, and he by check, and also he is giving you discount. So in order to do that, first let us check the totals on both the sides. So we have our credit side total, which is more I'm taking first, which is 37,000. Then the debit side total is 11,000. Now if you take the difference between these two, how much it would come to? 26,000. Now, so we actually have to pay 26,000 to Swami. So he is giving us a concession of 10%. He is giving us a concession of 10%. So 10% of 26,000 is 2,600. So actually we have to pay 26,000. As we are getting a concession of 2,600, we need to pay the balance, which is 23,400, which is 23,400. So how you are going to put these amounts, let us see. So since we are paying money, our entry would be Swami to bank, because we are giving a check. So Swami account has to be debited. So on the debit side, I am writing the amount of check that according to our calculation comes to 23,400. So 2 being the constant, since we are making the payment in check, I am writing the reason bank, and this is happening on 30th. Now, so while we are getting how much discount, 2,600, we are going to write that on the debit side and state the reason as reason of a concession is discount received. So that brings to the end of this problem. The total would be 37,000 on both the sides, as there is nothing more than that.